800 years ago, Kaulder and his friends worked as witch hunters to find the witch responsible for the Black Plague that had killed many people in their town. In the forest center, they find the witch queen responsible for controlling the swarm that kills the first soldier by emerging bees from his mouth. She then summons undead creatures which Kaulder wards off by his sword. The battle rages on, and while his friends fight back, Kaulder pursues the queen. On the way, he finds a toy lying on the ground, which reminds him of his dead family. When Kaulder awakens from his delusion and realizes that this isn't real, he begins fighting the witch. The queen pushes him through a hole in the tree and traps him with the roots, but Kaulder relights the sword and ignites a massive fire. Then stabs the queen to kill her. Before she dies, the queen curses him with immortality so that he'll forever live with his suffering loneliness. Nowadays, Kaulder is alive and works as a witch hunter. Currently, he's on a plane, and when he breathes at the window, he sees a symbol indicating the presence of magic. Using a pin on a glass of water as a compass, Kaulder finds the witch and then spills the water on the person on the seat next to her. Kaulder finds some ancient runes in her bag, and that's causing a storm that will make the plane crash soon. In fact, the plane suddenly begins to shake, but Kaulder grabs the runes and deactivates them, making the storm instantly goes away. Later, Kaulder visits his dear friend, Adolin, who works for the Axe and Cross organization. It's revealed that witches still exist and are allowed to live alongside humans as long as they don't use magic on them. Kaulder only intervenes when it's necessary to keep the peace. Adolin is retiring soon after 50 years of service, so Kaulder gifts him a pen to commemorate him. He also learns that they have already chosen the 37th Adolin, a young man that vows to watch out for Kaulder. Afterward, while the 37th Adolin is taking a cab, a mysterious Belial watches from afar. The next day, Kaulder receives a call informing him that the 36th Adolin died in his sleep. Devastated by the news, Kaulder attends the ceremony in which the young man is officially declared 37th Adolin. Then they go to the apartment to investigate the death of his old friend. Kaulder uses the usual tricks to check for elemental magic, like the breath on the window and a lighter, but there aren't any signs. However, when he's about to leave, he finds three dead insects and feels suspicious. He uses a special powder on the floor and reveals a pentagram, which suddenly explodes and makes runes appear on the walls. This confirms the room has been cursed with black magic and that his friend was murdered. When looking further, Kaulder discovers the pen is gone. He also finds a book with a bloody fingerprint and begins suspecting the new Adolin, but the guy reveals his burned hands to prove his innocence. When he was a kid, some witches set his house on fire, and Kaulder saved him from it. They visit a nearby bakery and sneak into the kitchen, where they discover that a powerful witch named Max is selling illegal uppers. Max tries to escape by conjuring a swarm of butterflies, but Kaulder stops him by capturing the insects in a jar. When questioned about a user of dark magic, Max denies any knowledge at first but eventually admits to selling a forbidden herb to a stranger. Max is blind and unable to describe the person, but he knows the scent of arsenic and rotten apples emanating from their body. Kaulder believes that the killer may be in a funeral parlor near an apple tree, so he sends Adolin home and goes to investigate alone. Meanwhile, a child finds a path of gummy bears on the street and follows it to a beautiful gummy tree near a bright house where Belial is watching. Kaulder stops the child and reveals that the gummies are actually rotten apples. The house turns old and ugly, and Kaulder enters to investigate it. Then he finds a scared young girl who is actually a warlock in disguise named Elek. The warlock attacks and stabs Calder's hand, but the wound heals quickly. Kaulder pursues Ellis and throws a knife at him, pinning him to a wall. After finding the pen, Kaulder knocks Elek out and takes him to the Council of Witches, where the 37th takes the chance to punch Elek for revenge. The council leader Glazer uses card reading to prove Elek is guilty. She ignores Calder's statement that Elek could not have acted alone due to the strength of the spell used. Glazer summons a frightening creature called the Sentinel and feeds Elek to it. Then Kaulder gets an idea when he notices a dead insect on Glazer's clothing. He checks on the 36th Adolin's body and uses a carved candle to prove the presence of magic. He checks Adolin's neck and finds another insect that proves he's actually been cursed by old-school black magic. The only way to eliminate the curse is to kill the warlock. Since Elek is dead, this proves he was working for someone. Kaulder also notices a cut on Dolan's finger and rechecks the book, finding multiple bloody fingerprints left on purpose to form a message, "Remember your death." Kaulder seeks help at a witch bar to recover his lost memories, but all the witches there are afraid of him except for the bar's owner, Chloe. He asks her for a memory spell, but she is hesitant because he hunts her clan. However, after learning it's for the sake of a friend, she agrees to help. She proceeds to put a memory potion inside a cherry and Kaulder eats it, causing him to see his burnt body in the cursed woods kneeling on the ground. Before he can see more, Belial intervenes and breaks the spell. Suddenly Kaulder is now chained to the floor, but he breaks the bones of his hands to free himself and goes after Belial. However, he is still affected by the spell and cannot fight well because he keeps seeing hallucinations of his past. Belial uses the chance to set the bar on fire. Chloe attempts to snap Kaulder out of his trance, but he thinks she is the witch queen and strangles her. She manages to blow a powder from a small cup and wakes him up just in time. Kaulder tries to catch Belial again, but Belial opens a root hole in the floor and disappears. Chloe tries to use a fire extinguisher without success and regrets the loss of her bar as it's all she has. She says Kaulder is a monster as everyone says. In the evening, Chloe hears a strange sound in her apartment and suddenly the lights explode and her feet are wrapped by vines as she is dragged down to hell. She tries to break free and sees Calder's hand reaching for her. Suddenly she wakes up realizing it was just a nightmare. Kaulder and the 37th Dolan are researching Belial. Kaulder asks Chloe for assistance and convinces her to join him in seeking revenge for her destroyed bar. Chloe agrees but needs ingredients for the potion, so she takes Kaulder to a friend's house. Upon arrival, Chloe is saddened to discover that her friend has been murdered and the valuable plants have been taken. A call is received from her friend's phone, but it is actually Belial who warns them of future attacks. Kaulder visits Danike to ask for the plants as they have no other choice. Danike agrees to help them out. But when Chloe examines the plants, Kaulder starts experiencing illusions of his family from the past. Danike was revealed to be a traitor, and as Chloe is caught by her employees, Kaulder becomes trapped in a memory spell. Although he is happy to see his family, Chloe interrupts and awakens him by persistently talking and pushing. Kaulder is taken away by Danique's men, but he manages to knock them out and saves Chloe. He then questions Danike about Belial's intentions, to which she denies knowing anything except getting him the plants he needed. Kaulder decides to leave without punishing her, but Chloe takes revenge by stealing Danique's magical gem and destroying it, which reveals Danique's real hideous face. Chloe reveals she can enter people's dreams without using any potions. She is scared of her ability as she accidentally caused her brother's death. Kaulder helps her by taking her to a place that shows the history of witches and encourages her to embrace her legacy. He also reminds her of his own immortality and supports her throughout the process. They revisit the night of the curse and find Calder's charred body, which roared when his friends came closer. When the first Dolan tried to destroy the queen's heart, Kaulder screamed in agony, revealing that killing the queen would also kill Kaulder. Chloe discovers that Belial murdered 36th Dolan because he knew the location of a hidden heart, which Belial plans to use to revive the queen. Belial abducts Max and takes him to the old woods, where he plans to offer him as a sacrifice to the witch queen by summoning her with the heart. Kaulder visits the cathedral and confronts the 37th Dolan for not informing him about the hidden heart. The young man tells Kaulder that the 36th Dolan had considered destroying the heart to free Kaulder. He also provides Calder's with the location of Belial's, which can be tracked. Kaulder reaches the woods and finds out that Max has been possessed by the Witch Queen. While he's there, Chloe appears and distracts him. Belial then launches an attack on Kaulder with fire magic, followed by bullets. However, Kaulder is able to react quickly and throws a knife to kill Belial. The Queen uses a distraction to stab Kaulder with a root and take back the immortality, explaining that she hadn't gifted it to him. He has just been keeping it safe until she could regain her body. Max transforms into the queen and attacks Kaulder, but Kaulder fights back and the queen disappears into a tree. Kaulder hurries back to the city and finds out that 36 Dolan has reawakened, but he is worried because he knows the queen will cast a black plague curse and he can't stop her. The Dolan reminds Kaulder he already killed the queen once and encourages him to try again. To prove himself to his friend, Kaulder retrieves a legendary sword plus a bunch of runes to arm himself. He then goes with Chloe and the 37 Dolan to visit the council room to keep the plague tree away from evil hands. The death of Glazer confirms that the queen plans to unleash the plague. They enter a secret corridor in the cave where the council held the arrested witches. They find Elec's body, which is causing a plague spell, and Kaulder breaks a wall to free it. Chloe enters Elec's mind while they are attacked by a sentinel. Kaulder and Dolan try to attack it with bullets and fire, but it is unaffected. Kaulder manages to push it away and using his sword and shoot at its weak spot, causing it to explode. Meanwhile, Chloe appears in Elec's mind and tries to stab him, but Alec fights her back and tries to kill her. After some struggle, Chloe manages to push back and throws him into the root hole, which instantly stops the plague spell. Chloe comes back to the real world while Kaulder pursues the queen, who generates a post-apocalyptic environment to confront Kaulder. Because Kaulder isn't mortal now. Every hit leaves a scar on him. After exchanging a few hits, Kaulder manages to stab the queen, but this only gets rid of the illusion. In reality, Kaulder sets his sword on fire with a rune and knocks down the queen. However, before he can finish her off, the 37th Dolan arrives and holds Chloe at gunpoint. The 37th Dolan, who is also a witch, reveals that his parents were the ones Kaulder killed when he was a child. The Dolan kills Kaulder and gives Chloe to the witch queen, who uses her to restart the chanting and ultimately unleashes the plague on the city. Dolan desires to receive magic as a reward, but the queen sees magicless people as useless and kills him with her swarm. Meanwhile, Kaulder begins dreaming about his family who encourages him to not give up, and when he wakes up, he uses a weather rune from the plane to create a lightning effect on his sword. He then throws the sword at the queen, killing her and regaining his immortality. After the city's recovery from the plague and the queen's demise, her heart continues to beat. Kaulder contemplates destroying it, but Chloe persuades him to stay, stating that the world still requires his assistance in battling witches and promises to stand by his side and protect the heart. Eventually, Kaulder informs the 36th Dolan of his resignation from the group and departs with Chloe to begin their next adventure.